off to outer space. We're leaving Mother Earth to save the human race. Our star blazers, a cry for help, a desperate plight, makes our star force reunite as we rush to meet our fate. The Comet Empire awaits. We must be strong and brave to stop its evil ways. If Zordar's plot should work, he'll destroy the universe. We'll fight the Comet Empire, battle through the raging fire, filled with the hope that Earth will survive. We'll keep peace alive with our star blazers.
General Dagon.
Yes, Admiral Smeardom?
Is the planet birth proving a problem?
It is just a matter of time, Admiral, before they surrender to me.
The Supreme Medal of the Empire will be waiting for you upon your victorious return from the campaign.
Thank you, Admiral Smeardom. Glory to the Empire.
In the center of the Galactic Nebula, supreme headquarters of the Galman Empire.
Gentlemen, the meeting is called to order. Admiral Smeardom of our Eastern Task Force will speak.
Our force has met with success and expects victory within a minimum of time. Our spearhead warships have begun final assault on planet Birth, and we expect it to surrender without much more fighting. And so, great Emperor Deslok, we will present three more planets for your birthday.
Smeardom?
Sir?
You are not only eloquent, but the shrewdest of my officers. I drink a toast to your skills.
Admiral Smellen, commander of our Western Task Force.
We too have met with much success, capturing 60% of the planets on our program.
At a loss of 40 spaceships.
Admiral? I'm sentencing you to exile.
No, Excellency.
To exile. If you lose any more campaigns.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
Next.
Now hear this, now hear this. Crew of the Argo, prepare for a time warp test to the planet Mars. Follow all warp procedures and stand by.
A warp is going to be difficult for the new crew members, isn't it?
Sure, that's why I decided to put them through a test.
Okay. Automatic ignition, pulse it.
Wave engine powered.
Energy building. Supercharger pulse.
I hope you new boys remember everything about warping that was crammed into your heads at the Space Institute. You're going into one for real this time. Just remember, it's worse the first time.
Didn't you hear the commander? We're gonna warp now. Better strap yourself in. Hurry up.
Never mind about him, Jason. Just worry about yourself. What did you learn about warping at the Space Institute? You're not sitting right, your belt should be tighter, and your seat back. Now you're ready.
10 seconds to warp. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Start warp! Test warp to Mars has been completed.
Check timing on thruster.
Checking thruster timing.
Normal.
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 Now let's find out if the ship and the crew are really prepared.
All hands, battle stations.
Target, enemy fleet at Mars.
Target ahead, prepare to fire.
All guns ready to fire.
Fire!
All direct hits.
It took 22 seconds.
Too slow. Continue firing practice. Sandor, go through the drills if we'd suffered a tail hit.
Okay, Skipper. Close bulkheads 3 and 7. Fire crew, repair crew on the double.
Oh, what's happened? I'm still in the warp. I blacked out.
What's wrong with you?
I'm lost somewhere in space. I never got out of the warp. Help, help me. Oh, thanks. I made it.
I saved you, dummy.
Thanks.
Medical crew, report to the aft station.
Bulkhead 3 and 7, closing.
Ouch!
We're just practicing.
You're supposed to save them, not injure them.
Cease fire! Release the dummy enemy vessel.
Range 43,000. 42.
Tigers, prepare to intercept enemy.
It's a bad time. Where you been, Contrail?
Sorry, Captain Conroy. We lost our way, sir.
The spaceship's so big, Captain.
Get to your cockpits. Hurry. Take off, Cosmo Tigers, full power.
What's the matter with you guys? You're late, 6-7, mate. Catch up to the rest of the formation. Quick.
Yes, sir. Here we come.
Begin attack formation with sight at the enemy.
Cosmo Tigers, you lost precisely 1 second between the first and second attack waves.
Next!
Me!
Let's pretend you hurt your brain.
Thanks a lot, Miss Aker.
A bumper. Here's a sticker. Next case. Hey, all the make-believe wounded are supposed to go back to work.
Jenna, you finished?
Not yet. You put in too much salt.
We're late. Serve them what's already ready. On the double, Jenna.
That's it, sir. We're past Mars 75,000 megameters to the asteroid belt.
We're so far from Earth.
Fire totally extinguished in aft departments.
All simulated wounded in hospital bay.
Repair work completed.
Good. Skipper, all simulated emergencies over. The crew did a good job.
I expected they would. Our next maneuver target is the asteroid belt.
Yes, Skipper.
Your lunch is served, Captain.
Ah.
Main enemy fleet sighted an asteroid belt.
Cosmo Tigers, return to the Argo.
Yes, sir.
Target placed on small asteroid. Argo will practice with live ammo.
Bearing 55 degrees port.
Range 7 megameters.
Turret 1 locked on target.
Firing. Your lunch, Captain.
Ah, great. Come on, men, let's get something to eat. I'm starved.
Captain, let me fire the guns.
Meh? You've been trained in gunnery?
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Okay. While I'm having lunch, show me what you can do.
Watch this, sir.
You missed that. I'm disappointed, Jenner.
Full speed ahead. We'll attack a simulated enemy base. Open all guns. Our target will be the asteroid numbered 70 on belt map 8.
All guns open.
Fire!
For 16 straight hours, the rigorous training continued. Everyone aboard the Argo was exhausted.
I feel like sleeping for the rest of my life. I'm so beat. Commander's a regular slave driver.
You can say that again.
What are you reading?
Oh, hello there, Jason. I'm studying about nutrition for a long trip.
No kidding.
I want you to see something. Come on.
Oh. Oh. Working as hard as I did today, maybe even harder, they come here for more practice?
Jason?
Sir?
Don't be too surprised about what you just saw, because here's something more.
During training, we were in the same class. We specialized in different areas of the Star Force, but we each vowed that we'd be best at what we would do. No matter how hard Commander Derek Wildstar works while on duty, he tries to improve his skills even in his spare time. He pushes himself to the limit because he knows only by keeping hair-trigger reactions will he be able to avoid any mistake that could jeopardize our mission. He knows that his timing must be of the utmost precision and accuracy when he gives the orders for the Argo to fire its cosmic cannons. And if we miss, we ourselves could be struck and destroyed by some unknown enemy, which may be waiting for us out there. And if that happens, it'll mean the end of the human race. We will have failed to find the new Earth on which mankind must live. So the skipper has no choice but to train hard, and I'm honored to serve him.
Well, Jetter, you're still awake. Aren't you tired?
Yes, sir, I am, but I feel too excited to sleep. I'm learning so much.
With that kind of spirit, you'll be a top-rank officer. That's good tea.
Another cup, sir?
I'd appreciate it. Thanks.
An alert!
We're going through another training maneuver?
It's for real.
Battle stations! Battle stations! All hands, man your posts!
Missiles, three of them! They're headed straight for us!
Keep the ship steady on course. Gunnery stations, prepare to fire!
On your toes, men! This is no practice drill! We're in a fight!
Turrets ready to fire.
Proton missiles, they're the same type that hit that space sightseeing ship.
Right. I wonder if Earth's their target.
I doubt it, Mark. From their heading, they seem to be stray missiles from somewhere way out there. Open fire! Here comes the second one. Mark, 30 degrees to port.
30 degrees.
Saw that? Those missiles came pretty close. Well, we could handle the problem because of our training.
And now do you understand why everybody tries to keep in top shape? The best example for all of us is Commander Wildstar. He's earned some rest after that. Come on, Jason, let us get some sleep.
Okay.
Jason had just learned one of the most important lessons of his life, that a large and diverse group of people, by developing and honing their many skills, could become a single powerful entity, with each strength dependent upon the others. The crew of the Argo had been tested in fire. Every man and woman aboard could feel proud. The nuclear fusion is growing inexorably on the sun. The end of the solar system was not long in the future. Where would mankind go? Press on, Argo.
press on, you have only 328 more days in which to find a new Earth.
Alive with our star.